Hey guys, what's going on? So, we've been messing with the GTO again, as usual. For starters, this car did sort of make a maiden voyage the other day. It made it to Man's Restoration to work and all the way home, which was pretty good. That's about an hour there, hour back.
About 130 miles or more.
Yeah, it ran nice and cool. It did well. The one thing that it had an issue with, though, is we were trying to do some burnouts in the parking lot, and the car decided to not cooperate for some reason. We figured out the issue relatively quickly, though. The throttle, the actual throttle assembly, the pedal had bent. If you have never looked at one, it's kind of like a V. So when you press on this, it pulls the cable inside, and that's what actually opens your carburetor. Somebody's going to do something with that. but yeah, that's actually what opens the carburetor and lets it get, you know, air and fuel.
And it was only pulling it about half open.
Yeah, if even.
He did manage, only a few guys hung around, maybe four when we were really leaving, and he managed to bend it by hand to get it to work.
Just
and then
one.
Got one pretty good one in, you know.
Yeah, I managed to walk one across the parking lot, but it, like I said, it wasn't doing very well.
We forgot to film it too because we were so mad.
Yeah.
And
well, that's disappointing.
Yeah.
But yeah, it did okay. It also tried to asphyxiate us on the way down. The fumes were getting pretty bad in the car. Even with the vent windows open, it was pretty bothersome. So when we got there, I went ahead and paneled off the fuel cell area in the back and the trunk and so on.
Yeah, because previously that hole where the rear seat used to be, that was still wide open.
Yeah.
That was a bad idea.
Yeah, it was not good. But we got there all right. At least it was warm enough, so all the windows were down and so on. So it wasn't too terrible, but it was unpleasant.
Jared and Dalton in the upholstery shop got us some materials so we could kind of patch it up.
I got to lay in my trunk on my fuel cell for a couple hours, gluing things down and so on. But it is a lot better now.
But honestly, it runs down the highway great.
Yeah.
It cruises really well.
It's all right. Mm-hmm. Yeah, the Turbo 400 obviously isn't a transmission that has overdrive, so it's going to be turning a little bit more RPM compared to like a 700R4, 204R, 4L80E, 4L60, that stuff. Those are all four speeds. But it's really not too much worse than the Trans Am, because when we take the Trans Am, I have such a, not such a big converter, but it has a bigger converter in it, bigger stall. So it's slipping a little bit if it's not locked up, and I'm usually cruising pretty quick down the interstate in that car too. So it's around the same RPM. It's not horribly unpleasant, but I might put some Flowmaster 2 chambers on it.
He installed a Innovate air fuel gauge on it, and that told us that it was running pretty rich, which a couple other people thought that as well, and so did we.
Yeah, we're well aware. But yeah, for the time being, we readjusted the float level one last time. It's doing a lot better now. We checked the fuel pressure. It's been pretty consistent. That gauge is not very accurate. It seems to be good one day and then bad the next. I don't know what's up with that. I'll probably replace it with another one I have down here.
Today we went down to Pat's Performance Parts Plus and got some air bleeds for the carb.
Yeah, just to try to lean it out a little bit more. Replaced all of them. Just to, you know, as a final little measure. If that doesn't do it, which it seems to have improved it quite a bit, all of those things, but I'll probably still end up getting in there and going through and taking out the main jets and putting new ones in.
It may be necessary. You'll have to run it down the road to find out. Right now it's raining, so it can't.
I don't have wipers hooked up yet.
But it does have 8 air bleeds on it, so he did the idle air bleeds front and back, as well as it has 4 high-speed air bleeds.
Yeah. And so I kept all my old ones and put them in boxes. They're labeled. So then when I end up inevitably going through this motor, which I probably will soon, I'll be able to, you know, hop it back up so it's a little bit more rich, run it a little more fat, especially if I wanted to throw nitrous at it or whatever I end up doing with it in the future. This motor is kind of a placeholder for what I want to build. This was just to get it down the road. It's got a mild, like a refresh kit in it, nothing really crazy. Small cam, aftermarket TRW pistons, stuff like that. Nothing really major. It's actually still a standard bore 400, so it was just pickle balled and put back together with new rings. It's nothing amazing. I intend to buy a whole stroker kit from Butler at some point here soon, and yeah, then taking that back out and doing it right.
But they have a stroker kit that's still a small journal, but you can punch it out to like a 461. That'd be quite a bit better.
Yeah. That way you get the benefits of the stronger webbing of the 400 compared to the 455 because of the smaller crank journals, but then you can still get big stroke out of it. Mm-hmm. The rods in these are very long too, and they have long rod assemblies so that you can, you know,
also, the smaller journals tend to want to rev a little bit more. Not yeah. a ton, but it'll rev a little bit more.
You're going to want to rev this like crazy. There are guys that do, though. You know, I will say, there are guys that have these that rev them to 7 and 8,000 RPM. Mm-hmm. You can do it. They actually had D-stroked a few of them, I believe, like 301.
Yeah, they tried one for like Trans Am racing down to a 303 or
303,
something.
303, yeah. And they rev pretty hard, but I will not be D-stroking anything.
This thing needs torque and a lot of it.
Yeah. Oh, I did actually scale the car the other day, and it came out to 3,335 pounds, which is a nice clean number. That's pretty good.
That's about a half tank of fuel, maybe just a hair under.
Yeah, and it was pretty good. We're both large. We weighed it with us in it. That was a demoralizing number. But
then went home and weighed ourselves in the exact clothes and everything and deducted it. Because with us in it, it'd be 4,000. No, I'm just kidding. No, it really was like 3,800, though, with us in it.
37, 38. But yeah, we weighed it. It comes out to about 33, 35. If you want to round up and say 34, it's not going to offend me. That's not bad, though, considering it's all steel right now. I do intend to buy a fiberglass hood for it, and maybe a whole fiberglass front end. I really don't know. But yeah, that's about the same weight that the Trans Am is right now with the 4-point, well, it's actually 6, but 4-point roll bar in the back. So that's not too bad for what, you know, these would have weighed probably 3,600, 3,700. I think depending on your options.
Well, yeah.
You could probably get it down to 35, but.
Oh, could fire it up again so they can hear it now. And you could do a couple revs and then maybe, I don't know, maybe do a burnout. Although we already did one. We'll see how it fires up here. Smoky in there. When you revved it, it blew some of it out, though, at least. But it sounds pretty good.
Yeah, I like the Flowmasters on this.
I mean, ultimately, this thing's gonna end up with a whole lot more power, but it's at least enough power right now to have a little fun with it, you know. And it'll get it down the road and cruise.
I'm not gonna leave my car looking like this and have 350, 400 horsepower. I mean, it needs to have like 650 or 7 or some ignorant number.
Yeah.
So it'll wind up that direction at some point soon.
But it's coming along. Smoky in here now.
Whew. Is that sufficient?
That'll do for tonight. That's enough money wasted, I think, on tires.
Hey, as far as I'm concerned, it redeemed itself for not being able to do anything at work.
Yeah.
At least it does it here.
We actually did two of them tonight, so I'll probably lead the video off with one, which you probably already saw, and then another one here at the end. So. Yeah. But anyway, guys, we do really appreciate you watching this project. There's a lot to do yet. There's like, who knows? I mean, interior panels. He is going to probably change things on the paint at some point, but you know, when he feels like it. People keep asking.
Probably not gonna. Yeah. And if you guys keep saying dumb things in the comments, I'm gonna put a Cleveland Ford motor in this just to make Pontiac Puris mad, because we get some dumb comments lately. Not from regulars that watch our channel, but just from...
Yeah, I mean, it's like 95% great people, obviously. Oh, yeah. But, you know, you got a handful.
You got a few of you guys that we're banning. So, just remember, it's going to take you a minute to form that thought and type it, and it's going to take like 2 seconds for us to immediately kick you off of our channel. So, anyway, this is my red, gray, black, whatever, GTO. And, as usual, we really appreciate you guys watching. We really do. And we appreciate the positive comments that we get and the support for our channel and my car builds and so forth. So thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye.